We're coming at you from the Peak, Chesapeake Energy Arena in beautiful Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, as the Thunder prepare to take the floor. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Doris Burke. Also joining us from the sidelines, David Aldridge. Last outing for Minnesota, they won that game against the Lakers. And that result, guys, was a real shocker. It was just about as complete a dominant performance as we've seen them.
And guys, they just got so many good looks in that one, and the defense never able to affect their offensive rhythm.
Well, I think the defense from the other team was simply porous. There's no other way to put it. So many openings, and they made them pay for it.
And nothing tips off a broadcast like getting the lowdown from the sidelines. And we've got David Aldridge there for that. David, good evening.
Well, guys, we know Russell Westbrook is a fearsome competitor, but he says you never know how long you'll be able to run like this or jump like this. So I go for it every time. I may look angry, but it's the only way I know. Yes, you look angry. Kevin?
Yeah, he's special, D.A., absolutely. Thanks. Well, we're about halfway through the season outdoors. It's no longer new. The playoffs are still a ways away. Seems like a time when players can start to lose focus.
No doubt, Kevin. You have that sense that maybe the All-Star break is coming or going, and you still have that fight you've got to get through, the February-March doldrums. But this is why coaches always talk about, let's play in the moment. Let's not worry about the results, what you can do every day, each moment. When you can do those kinds of things and just lock in on small tasks, then you've got a team that can contend.
Good coaches always seem to steer their teams in the right direction at this time of the year. We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. And so in the game for the Timberwolves, Gibson plays the four with Towns in the middle. Then it's Wiggins, then there's Teague, and he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
Well, that takes concentration from Jeff Teague, Kevin, right? He's got to convert through contact. Remarkable strength. Pretty good style, too. Not bad.
Jeff Teague replacing Ricky Rubio at the point guard position for the Timberwolves. Doris, did you like that change?
You know what I did, Kevin? They're drastically different players. Rubio probably the better defensive player, definitely the more prolific passer, but the shooting was always an issue. With Teague, you get a guy who can knock down three-point shots, and he's one of the best point guards in the league at dribble driving into the paint and getting some action off that.
Here's Oklahoma City now. It's a three-point game. Defeated by the Wizards in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
You know what? That's a game where the coach might just want to burn the video, because there's no question they're a better team than what we saw, but they got crushed on that night.
They slept walk through that entire effort. Way too much talent on the roster for them to let that happen.
Here's Wiggins following the basket by Russell Westbrook. Five to shoot. Pulls up. The rebound by Grant. And it's Westbrook with the ball. He brings it up for the Oklahoma City Thunder. From 13, that shot misses. And Minnesota now the other way. Wiggins outside. Pass to Teague. Good D by Westbrook. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. Ferguson kicks to George. Releases. Gets to the corner and buries it.
You can see there's complete trust in Paul George and pick and rolls. Fantastic at taking advantage of the defense and the separation they give him.
Now here's Teague. He picked up 15 points in their last win against the Lakers.
Yeah, Kev, he was a standout on the backboards that night and got a number of big rebounds.
Now here's Grant. Jeff Teague unable to get his shot to go. Grant kicks to Ferguson. Out of bounds, Minnesota takes possession. Why don't we go to the 2K leaderboard? Over the past month, these teams have been playing a very entertaining brand of basketball. The Thunder in fourth.
I mean, they have really hit their stride in terms of that transition game. No doubt about it. They are playing at a great pace.
Timberwolves trail. The Thunder, probably the best team in the league at creating extra opportunities.
And they do it in two ways, Kevin. They are a team that emphasizes offensive rebounds and forcing turnovers. So they make you feel them, and they make things happen with their activity.
And that's what you give up when you don't fight over the screen.
Right. The effort could have been so much better. You've got to be willing to fight through that screen. There's no question about it.
Now, here's Adams. Good on the shot.
Playing in a crowd is nothing unfamiliar to Steven Adams. In fact, I think he enjoys it.
Teague against Westbrook. Here's Towns. Shot's good by Gibson.
Timeout, timeout.
Gibson's got his first 2 points.
A guy who converts well at the rim, you like to see the aggression there.
Really doesn't get any easier than that. The defense didn't look too interested in stopping him.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder. Home court didn't seem to help any last time they met. We'll see if it makes a difference this time.
And they lost a close one last time they saw each other. And you have to think that it was the foul trouble that really kept them from getting the win.
Yeah, some of their starters had to take an early seat on the bench, and that ruined the rhythm and flow they were trying to establish.
Catching up on the changes for Oklahoma City. Nerlens Noel checks in for Steven Adams. Patterson comes in for Jeremy Grant. Alex Abrines has checked in for Terrence Ferguson. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Russell Westbrook. Outside Rose. A minute 50 left here in the first quarter. Here's Jang. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
Well, the definition of an effort player. Zhang shows off that high motor, converts off the glass. Nice.
Gorgui Dieng, the 21st pick in 2013 out of Louisville. He's more than lived up to that selection.
Well, let's remember, this is a national champion we're talking about. The Louisville Cardinals won it with him anchoring them defensively. He's also shown a nice shooting touch in the mid-range game in the professional leagues. But I think it's his defense that still remains the strength of his game.
And there's a minute 45 left in the first quarter. Schroeder passes to George. Over Wiggins. And there's Paul George on the assist by Schroeder. George has got his second basket.
Boy, hitting for good percentage here in the first quarter. He's doing what he can to get his team off on the right foot.
Sharge outside. And Bayless kicks to Wiggins. Down to five on the shot clock. Minnesota shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific. 79% as a team.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. And Doris, the Wolves, a lot of promise, but how do they deliver?
I think Tom Thibodeau says it best, Kevin. It's the little things. The magic is actually in the work you put in every day. No shortcuts, no easy way out. There's a price to be paid for winning in the NBA.
Thunder trailing by four. Schroeder finds Patterson. Now George. That three off the mark. Wiggins surveying the floor. There's 53 seconds left to play in the first. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession.
All right, a chance here to check out the stats for Paul George. He's been dominant over the last month. He's putting up 31 points per, 8 rebounds, and almost 2.5 steals. He has been terrific throughout, putting up some huge numbers offensively.
Well, and this is exactly who he is, a flat-out scoring machine. You plug him in and let him go to work.
Now here's Wiggins. He's coming off a 28-point game against the Lakers.
Yeah, don't forget how great he was drawing contact and getting himself to the free throw line. Picked up a ton of easy points there. Kev, love the connection Noel has built with his teammates. Smart at knowing when to time that alley-oop.
And a tremendous Unleash Chaos replay coming to you courtesy of Under Armour Hover Havoc. Šarić against Patterson. The baseline J misses off the left iron. And it's Schroeder with the ball. He brings it up for Oklahoma City. Trailing by two. And it's Abrines in the corner. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. The Timberwolves on top, up two. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. All-star big man Karl Anthony Towns is hungry to maximize his potential.
I want to be the best player who ever played, and I feel that I could do that. I think I have the God-given talent and the God-given abilities to make it happen, and I have total confidence in myself every single day I wake up that I could be the greatest player who ever played. I know if I continue to put the work ethic in and continue to do all the little things I need to do, I could find myself in that conversation. But, you know, obviously I got to learn every single day and never take no days for granted.
On his coaches, Greg, and teammates love hearing them.
And how can you not? I mean, that kind of drive is special. And with his tools and potential, hard to put a ceiling on just how good he can be.
And this has been a fairly close game through the first quarter, and we'll see what happens here in the second. And guys, what's your take so far on the Timberwolves?
They've gotten to the line with tremendous consistency here through the first period.
And this is why coaches say be aggressive. As long as you're playing smart, good things tend to happen, even if you're on the road.
On the court for the Timberwolves as our second quarter is underway. Jones is out there with Rose. Then it's Dario Šarić. Then it's Andrew Wiggins. And it's Jang in at the five, roaming the paint. Well, the grimace of pain tells it all. He's hurt, and let's hope he's okay.
And boy, this really doesn't look good. That just the way it happened.
Boy, it's got to be so frustrating for him. As hard as he has worked, doing everything he can to help his team. Just heartbreaking, Greg.
Who are some of the players you watch that get stronger as the game goes on? They're not cut down by fatigue and still have that energy, something left in the tank.
Those guys who show me superhuman strength a la Kevin Harlan. Those guys who come to mind, LeBron James, that's a bad man. It doesn't matter if it's the first minute or the 48th minute. Russell Westbrook is indefatigable. His stamina and his ability to dominate in triple overtime once is absolutely incredible. And then what did we see from Anthony Davis when Boogie Cousins went down? A man who for 48 minutes on both ends is a problem. Those three men, Kev.
Endless energy. And here's Jang after Paul George getting his three to go. Šarić inside. Patterson's there. Oh, and a fast break for Oklahoma City. Here's Schroeder, and he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. And Greg, certainly the knock on Dennis Schroeder is play on the defensive end.
Nobody questions how effective he is on offense. I just think he has a tendency to take a few too many plays off and too many chances on defense. If he wants to be viewed as a top point guard in this league, he'll need to show some consistency on the defensive end.
That one drops. He ties it up. Year after year, the Timberwolves have the NBA's most grueling travel schedule. A lot of miles to cover in the West.
Kevin, if you add up their flights in a season, they could circle the globe more than twice. And let's remember, there's no frequent flyer miles here either.
Catching up on the changes for Oklahoma City. Adams, he's checked in for Noel. Jeremy Grant comes in for Patrick Patterson. And it's Russell Westbrook in for George.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Okogie. Westbrook against Teague. From the right block, the shot is good. Teague's got five now.
And another lead change. The fans are really getting their money's worth here tonight.
Well, this is what they pay to see, right? Competitive, close games are simply the best to be involved in.
Now, here's Westbrook. He's coming off a 22-point game against Washington.
And even if you took away his points, he was still an offensive force because of his passing. His assist numbers were tremendous.
The drive by Schroeder. Over Teague. And the shot is long.
You know, he's working on his inside game, but clearly there's still a little more work to do.
Pass to Gibson. Kicks it to Jones. Trying to find Towns. Gets it to him. Shoots over Adams. And that one is off. And the Thunder going the other way now. Schroeder against Teague. Puts it up from 15. Westbrook, no good.
Oh, a lapse defensively, and they actually get away with it. Bad idea to leave him open consistently, though.
A different look for Oklahoma City. Ferguson's checked in for Diallo. And it's Felton in for Dennis Schroeder. Minnesota also with the sub. Bayless is checked in. And so it's Minnesota with it. They've only allowed 5 points in the quarter. Gibson dishes to Teague. Five on the clock. Fires the three. Buries it from three-point range. Teague's got the lead up to four now for the Timberwolves.
He's been a marksman this period. The shot mechanics finally in sync. I think the one constant with Tom Thibodeau is you can always hear his voice the entire game. Doesn't matter if you're up 20 or down 20, you will hear Tom Thibodeau on the sideline.
Timberwolves leading by four. It's hauled in by Felton. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 1-6 from the field in the second quarter. It's been a rough period so far. Westbrook, and that comes off the assist by Raymond Felton. Westbrook's got his second basket of the night. And it's Teague with the ball, but he brings it up for the Timberwolves. And hearing Coach Tom Thibodeau, some have described his voice as part growl, part bark.
He's very intense, Kevin. And I think the one thing you know about Tom Thibodeau, he likes to say, there is a price to pay. It's all about the work you put in.
Now, here's Grant. After the miss from Karl-Anthony Towns, here's Westbrook, and the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
You must respect the strength of Russell Westbrook. Boy, even when you foul him, he can still finish.
Russell Westbrook's mantra is, why not? Way of daring himself to greater heights.
I think, Kevin, in time, it became a way to build confidence to take on the world. That why not? Who says you can't? He lives by that maxim, and I love it, Kevin.
And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point.
when you think about Thunder coach Billy Donovan taking over in 2015, he came in as a two-time NCAA champion at Florida and one of only four individuals to play and coach in a Final Four. Incredible stuff. His shot's hitting on another level here in the second. I mean, it's looking effortless now.
Grant kicks to Felton. Outside Westbrook. Passes it to Abrines. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. That one is on Towns.
Well, Steven Adams is as strong a player as there is in the NBA. Draws the contact there.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
Throw good, Adams.
Boy, there's just a brute strength and physicality about Steven Adams. This guy knows his role and plays it to perfection.
Catching up on the changes for Oklahoma City. Nerlens Noel comes in for Jeremy Grant, and it's Paul George in for Russell Westbrook. And a change for the Timberwolves. Jang, he's checked in for Jeff Teague. And so Adams nails both of them. Timberwolves have gone 4-10 in the second quarter from the field. Rose kicks to Zhang. Timberwolves passing it around. Towns, the shot, no good. Adams, some nice D.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Šarić passes to Zhang. Here's Bayless, and he uses the glass on the layup. Bayless has got his first points of the night.
Well, Gorgui Zhang is a big man, is an excellent passer. That's a pretty look.
Felton kicks to George. Over Šarić. Here's Adams. No good on the last second attempt there. And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Timberwolves lead by one. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thank you. Andrew, the energy and effort were apparent throughout that first half. How were you able to do it?
We had a good practice, you know, working hard, really putting things together. Keep doing that, we can come out with a W.
Hey, thanks for your time. We appreciate it. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, hoop fans. NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. EJ, Shaq, Jet.
It was a closely contested first quarter for Minnesota. They did jump out to a lead in the opening period, but 4 points was the biggest it got. They were outscored by just a bit in the second quarter as they go into the break now holding just a 1 point advantage. And Kenny, what did you see out there from the Timberwolves?
Well, it's always a little bit of a challenge playing on the road, but they came in mentally prepared and physically prepared. The energy in the arena was fierce, but they didn't cave in.
And big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Thunder.
Well, their reserves haven't contributed much. It's fine to ask your starters to do the heavy lifting, but don't leave them out in the cold. I think this could easily become a bigger issue as the game wears on.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See everybody with Kevin Harlan.
Welcome back to Oklahoma City, everyone. You can see Chesapeake Energy Arena there in the background as the cars stream down I-40. And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. Without question, Jeff Teague displaying his skills today.
Well, they've done a good job of letting the game come to them, and really few forced shots here so far.
I think, Greg, we're seeing a couple things. Terrific play calling, unselfish nature, and quality shooting. That makes for good offense.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. The forwards, George and Grant.
Westbrook and Ferguson, their backcourt, and it's Adams in at the center, filling out the middle. That's the lineup out there for the Thunder. Now here's Towns. The pass to Gibson. Count it. Gibson's got the first bucket of the third here for the Timberwolves. Doris, when you talk about coaching, aside from wins and losses, how can you gauge if a coach is doing a good job?
Well, you make a great point, Kevin, because if an organization is in a rebuild situation, then winning is almost impossible because you're outgunned and outmanned every single night. So to evaluate those coaches, here are the things I would look at. One, are you maximizing the talent at your disposal? Are your player development skills at such a degree that you're seeing incremental improvement from the guys on your roster? And then ultimately, Kevin, are guys playing hard? Are they competitive every night? Even if the wins don't necessarily show in the box score and at the end of the, you know, the regular season, the reality is, are you playing hard? Are you competitive?
The first free throw is good.
And Paul George, a terrific two-way player, an all-star, an all-NBA performer, and multiple all-defense selections.
And both free throws good for Paul George. And Paul George has made it a goal to win Defensive Player of the Year.
I mean, he's got tremendous length and quickness, but really his pride at that end of the floor might matter even more. He just takes great pride in being a complete player.
Towns with the bucket.
I mean, guys, how good is the form and the release? Carl Anthony Towns capable in the mid-range as well.
Westbrook kicks to George. Ferguson, the pass to Westbrook. Now George, Teague covering. From 13, out that one in, and the Timberwolves lead is cut back down to 1 point on the basket from George. Outside Teague. Sharge outside. Adams against Towns. Shoots over Adams, and Towns gets it to go. Towns has got his second basket of the night.
Marvelous start to the second half, 3 for 3.
Ferguson kicks to Westbrook. Pulls up on the elbow. Back to Adams. Pass to Ferguson. Just 3 to shoot. Another shot. That one misses. So Minnesota will take it the other way. Time now for an injury report. Let's find out the news on Andrew Wiggins. David, what's the update?
Well, guys, I had a moment to catch up with Minnesota's head athletic trainer. Unfortunately, it sounds like a very serious injury. We're well into this season, and that is the last thing this team needed. And that's going to make things much harder for them down the road. Kevin?
All right, David, thanks. Well, guys, certainly not the news his fans were hoping for.
Yeah, not at all. I mean, it sounds like he's got a long road ahead of him in terms of his recovery.
And our hearts go out to him. The guy works so hard. His teammates love him. Coaches love him. He's going to be missed. You know, missed that one, but still a really good start coming off the break. 3 for 4 now. When you think about the Oklahoma City Thunder, you have to start and end the conversation with the historic regular seasons put on by Russell Westbrook. The one thing you have to wonder, has he taken them as far as he can?
Now, here's George. He's got 11. And it's out of bounds. They say last touch by Adams.
A moment here to see the numbers for Towns. 6th in blocks, 8th in rebounding. And he's right up there in the top 20 in scoring. Certainly a force to be reckoned with offensively.
And his ability to patrol the lane is a difference maker for that team. Exceptional timing and anticipation. That's why he's a top 10 shot blocker. And the Timberwolves call time here. Why don't we take this chance now to show you the most active wing defenders in the league? These are this season's steals leaders at small forward. Paul George on top.
And with the kind of defense he plays, it really gives his team someone to lean on at that end of the floor.
And it's Paul George with the foul. That's foul number two for him. Nerlens Noel checks in for Adams. Jones looking for an opening. A floater. And it's Noel with the rebound. Thunder trailing by three. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
And that one's good. Schroeder.
The passing skills of Paul George are simply impressive. This guy is terrific at realizing when he needs to give it up.
And Zhang kicks to Jones. Westbrook with the steal. And now here's George, the fast break opportunity. And there's the call on Karl Anthony Towns. That's his third foul of the game. And the Thunder making a change here. Abrines has checked in. Here's Noel. And trying for the go-ahead basket. It doesn't go in. Outside Rose. There's 1:54 left in the third quarter. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
Boy, that's high impact defense in the lane, standing tall to deny the easy bucket.
The sturdy Patrick Patterson, the 14th pick out of Kentucky back in 2010.
What you love about Patrick Patterson is he's turned himself into a three-point specialist over the course of his career. You know on a night-by-night basis what you're going to get on the defensive end, and that is a multi-positional defender who's going to give you great effort every single time out. There's something to be said about Patrick's ability to adjust and evolve his game as the NBA has evolved.
Shot clock at three. Jones, that's for two. Here's Towns, a second chance effort. He takes it up and lays it in. Towns has got six.
Boy, how about the anticipation from Karl Anthony Towns? Beats everyone to the spot and goes right back up with it.
And a quick look at how the Oklahoma City Thunder's schedule is shaping up. On Thursday, they'll be playing against LaMarcus Aldridge and the San Antonio Spurs. And then on Saturday, the Atlanta Hawks come into town. That will tip off a homestand for them.
And for that game against the Hawks, this is one where it would take a complete meltdown for them not to come away with the win. Anything can happen, but I'd be shocked if they don't come out on top.
Now here's Jones, still looking for his first bucket in this one. From 20 feet out, that one no good. And Oklahoma City will go with it the other way. There's the feed to Schroeder. Noel trying to break loose, and it's Schroeder missing.
Unbelievable. He blew that look, guys. No clue what went wrong there.
And Bayless kicks to Jones. Pass to Towns. Good on the bucket. He's got eight.
Well, this guy's been a prolific scorer on the interior from his first day in the league. Karl Anthony Towns getting the job done in the painted area.
We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. The Timberwolves on top. They're up by three. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get started for the fourth quarter. And let's take now this moment to bring up our State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
And, Greg, nothing better than chemistry, right? Working together to create a bucket.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. And a look at the five for the Timberwolves to start the fourth. We've got Teague. George is out there with Karl-Anthony Towns. And it's Rose. George, no good.
He's cold from deep. Zero threes in the second half after hitting just one in the first.
It's hauled in by George.
You know what? They're winning, though, despite the fact that he has just been really off.
Feeds it to Noel. George trying to break free. And it's Noel missing. Okogie defended by George. Kicks it to T. From the stripe. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Lined it up and knocked it down. His second triple tonight.
George has gone 5 of 12 from the field. Teague against Felton. Teague finds Towns. He can't hit that time. Some solid defense from Grant. We're just over a minute and a half now into the fourth. Back to George. Lock at six. Back to Felton. Over Teague. Will not go. This is off the front iron. For Minnesota, they've gone 0-3 to start the fourth quarter. Okogie defended by George. Okogie. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
Boy, he has been cold for a while now.
Yeah, starting to look like it's taking its toll mentally. He doesn't look like himself.
Now here's Felton to take the lead. And it's Jeff Teague with the rebound. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. And off the front iron, and in it goes. And the Timberwolves lead by two.
But Jeff Teague really starting to percolate, boy. When he finds his rhythm, he is dangerous.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. And you look at Jeff Teague now with a decade in the league out of Wake Forest. Greg, what does he bring to the table aside from the fact that he's been in the playoffs every single year of his career?
Yeah, I mean, he's an explosive slasher and really has grown as a playmaker. Not a star, but a quality starting point guard.
A different look for Oklahoma City. Steven Adams, he's checked in for Noel. Terrence Ferguson comes in for Diallo. And Russell Westbrook is subbed in for Raymond Felton. Taj Gibson's checked in for Minnesota. And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, during the break, I listened in on Billy Donovan's huddle with his team. He said, guys, we need to play with pace, and that'll get us some early fast break opportunities. We're playing way too predictable right now, guys.
Okay, David, much appreciated. Here's Ferguson. Not going to go that time.
And you know they wanted that one to go down.
Let's prove a time. Fourth quarter. Don't get it done now. No more chances.
Now here's Westbrook. Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. Can't connect from short range. Timberwolves leading by four. Pass to Towns. He kicks to T. Back to Towns. Just 5 on the clock. That's good. And so T with the assist. 11 points for Karl-Anthony Towns. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Westbrook with the bucket.
Westbrook demands the basketball and says, I got you, fellas. The big-time delivery.
And the Timberwolves call time here. They're leading by 5. 1:51 left in the fourth. And now we get the chance to present our Jordan Player of the Game, Karl Anthony Towns.
And his rebounding has been an anchor for him tonight, as usual. He's into double digits again in that department. And it just takes so much pressure off their other players knowing he's got the glass work covered.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Bayless is checked in. Towns down low. Adams defending. And it's Towns missing. To the middle. Here's George. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. That one is on Towns.
We call that masterful use of the pump fake. Paul George effective getting guys to jump on it.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He hits the first one, and that shrinks the margin to just four.
Well, Paul George smack dab in the middle of the prime of his career, and maybe underestimated is his drive to win.
Teague is checked in for Jared Bayless. And both free throws good for Paul George.
That's exactly who they want at the line, and he comes through again.
Teague the pass to Towns. Towns is double. Paul George with the steal. And now here's George, the fast break opportunity.
See, I don't think you can teach that. Paul George going right into contact. You love that aggressiveness.
Shots.
He drops the first one, and that brings them within two. He's perfect from the line this time. There's 1:17 left in the fourth quarter. T kicks to Towns. Adams, a nice D.
Affecting the shot in a big way there. Excellent defense.
Well, you talk about getting into the space of the shooter. This is how you defend the paint.
Minnesota with the ball. Paul George missing from long range.
Now, this is a big physical guy himself. And Towns finds other teams trying to bump him off his game.
First, and that will put them up by two.
You know, Karl Anthony Towns has said he wants to be considered the best player in the league. He's got the offensive game, the versatility, the length, the mobility. Let's see what happens.
Second one is good. And both at the line, and it's a three-point game.
And that's how you do it. Free throws can make a huge difference in a tight game.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're trailing by three. There's 49 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Luol Deng is checked in for Minnesota. There's 49 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Here's Adams. Doesn't go that time. Towns with the defensive effort. I think we'll see them burn the clock a bit here.
Yeah, smart move.
Paul George grabs the miss. And here's George. He'll bring it up for Oklahoma City. It's a three-point game. There's the steal. Teague with the ball. 3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. The pass to Towns. Just four to shoot. And an intentional foul right there.
Man, it took forever for them to commit that foul. I don't know why they didn't do it right away. Those are precious seconds.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall.
What you love about Taj Gibson is his leadership. This guy is an intelligent, ferocious competitor who plays his role to a T.
That's good. Going 1-2 from the line, and that gives them a four-point cushion. Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're behind by four. 3 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
And I'm sure the coach is telling them it ain't over till it's over. Yeah, but I don't know.
Here's Grant, off target. So it's Minnesota taking the W in a close one. They seem to relish their role as the bad guy here tonight.
You know, Kevin, I sense that as well. I mean, they really did feed off all of that negative energy this crowd was directing at them. I mean, they turned it around and used it as motivation to close out a significant win.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Andrew, an impressive win for you guys. How will you look back on tonight?
It feels great, you know. And I think the whole team played great. You know, we shared the ball. We grabbed rebounds. We made big possessions. You know, so I think it was a great game.
Hey, Andrew, congrats again. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time.